Now let's discuss the solution for the active power quiz. What we had was that to achieve some frequency, we needed to increase voltage beyond some point. And we knew that at 1 volt and 2 gigahertz, the power was 30 watts. So the question is, what is the power for the most power efficient setting? And what is the power for the highest performance setting? The most power efficient setting will be the one with the lowest frequency and the lowest voltage. Why? Because the power, if you remember, is equal to something times voltage squared times frequency. So we need to have, to reduce power, we need to both lower the frequency and reduce voltage. So our most power efficient setting is this one. Relative to this setting, the power for the most efficient setting is going to be equal to, so this stands for our efficient power, it's going to be 30 watts times, the voltage is now 0.9 of what it was. So it's 0.9 squared times, the frequency now is 1.8 over 2, so this is again 0.9 of what it was, and when we multiply this out, we get 21.9 watts, or 22 watts. So the answer here is that the power is 21.9 watts. Now let's do the same, but this time for the highest performance setting. The highest performance setting is the one that gives us the highest frequency. What we have now is the power for the performance is going to be equal to 30 watts times, the voltage is now 1.5 times what it was. So it's 1.5 square times, the frequency is 3 instead of 2 gigahertz, so that has also increased by a factor of 1.5. And if you multiply this out, we get 101.3 watts. So as you can see, there is a huge difference between the most power efficient and the highest performance setting, although in fact the difference between these two settings is not even a factor of 2 in performance. Why? Well, because power is not only proportional to frequency, it's also proportional to voltage squared, and reducing the frequency allows us to reduce the voltage.